Hello students, my name is Ishan Mudgal and today we are going to discuss the topic from the subject network theory, and the topic is equipotential, or you can say equivalent resistance. See, today we are going to discuss the question from the GATE 2018. Yes, and this type of question has been come many times in a previous GATE exam, and this concept is very easy. But you have to follow the steps to solve this type of question. Okay? First, we will see the question and then I will tell you different methods to solve it. Okay? So, the question is, consider a network shown below with R1 equal to 1 ohm, R2 equal to 2 ohm and R3 equal to 3 ohm. The network is connected to constant voltage source 11 volt. The magnitude of current in ampere through the source is. So, in this question, we have to find the current passed through the 11 volt source, which means we have to find the current I. Okay? So, what is the given? We have given this network and the resistance of values R1 equal to 1 ohm, R2 equal to 2 ohm, R3 equal to 3 ohm. Now, see, we will use the concept of symmetry here. Okay? We can also use the concept of equidistance. So, we will see this question by the concept of symmetry. See, the first step or the careful step to see the symmetry concept or to use the symmetry concept is to see the network. If you see, there are multiple resistance in a network and resistance value are repeating, then you can use the symmetry concept there. Okay, for using the symmetry concept, follow the steps carefully. So, step first, we will draw the line of symmetry. Okay, line of symmetry, that line of symmetry can be horizontal, can be vertical. Okay, first we will draw a line of symmetry here for this network. You can draw either horizontal line of symmetry or vertical line of symmetry. So, in this, we are drawing the vertical line of symmetry. Okay? Why it is a line of symmetry? By drawing this line of symmetry, you can see both network, left hand side and right hand side are same or mirror image of each other. So, this is a line of symmetry, which is the first step. Second step, identify the line of symmetry. There are two types of line of symmetry. First, perpendicular line of symmetry. Second, parallel line of symmetry. Okay? Perpendicular line of symmetry and parallel line of symmetry. To identify the line of symmetry, we have to draw the axis. What is the axis? Axis is the terminals or an imaginary line drawn between the terminal across which you have to find the resistance. Okay, which means this one is the axis here. Now see, if line of symmetry is parallel to the axis, it will be the parallel line of symmetry. And if line of symmetry is perpendicular to the axis, it will be a perpendicular line of symmetry. Okay, so see carefully in this diagram. Line of symmetry, this one is parallel to it. So, for this line of symmetry, it is a parallel line of symmetry. Okay? Now, most important step for which we have to draw the symmetry line. The step is to find the equipotential points. The whole symmetry concept is used to find the equipotential points. Okay? Now, listen carefully. If line of symmetry is parallel, like this question, then the branch which is perpendicular to it are contain equipotential points. I will repeat again. If there is a parallel line of symmetry, the branch which are perpendicular to it contain equipotential points. So, let us suppose here I am giving the name A, B, C, D, E. Okay? Here I give the name. See here. The branch which is perpendicular to it. So, which branches are perpendicular to this line of symmetry? Branch BC and branch ED. other lines are at some angle. You can see here. Okay. So, this line, this branch, which are perpendicular to the line of symmetry, contain equipotential points, which means BC and ED are equipotential pairs. B, C and E, D are equipotential pair. Okay, are equipotential pair. So, this is for this, only for equipotential concept, we use the symmetry concept. Now, we will redraw our diagram taking these two pair as equipotential pair. Okay, now you know, you can either short circuit this branch BC or ED or open circuit the branch. Why? Let us suppose we have a branch containing resistor I and we have two point Vx and Vy voltage. Now, if Vx is equal to Vy, if Vx is equal to Vy, what will happen? The current will be zero as well as potential difference is also 0 volt, right? Now, both current and potential difference is 0. So, you can either short circuit this branch or open circuit the branch. It will not affect your analysis. Because in this branch, neither the current is flowing. Also, this is a short circuit branch, okay? So, the same concept will be used in this diagram. We can either short circuit the branch BC or open circuit the branch BC and both DE. Okay. Now we will redraw the diagram by taking this concept. Okay. Now see, BC and DE are equipotential pairs. So we can short circuit it. Short circuit means we will bring two nodes B and C and make it as a one node. Okay. We have one node A. Then there will be a second node B, C. Yes, because they are equipotential pairs. Then we have third node E, D. And last, we have F. Okay. Take this point as. Okay. Now we will redraw our network. See, from A, there is two resistance going towards B and one towards C. So, from A, there is two resistance going, one towards B and one towards C. Yes or no? And the naming is R1 and R1. Okay? Now, from B, we have two resistance towards E and towards D, R1 and R3. From B, we have two resistance to the point D and E, one is R1, one is R3. Similarly, from point C, we have again two resistance, one towards R1 and one is R3. Okay? R1, R3. Okay? Now, we have two resistance remaining, one from E, one from D towards F, and both points are same because they are equipotential points. So, like this, having R1 and R1. And across this, we have a 11 volt source. So first, we will find the total resistance and divided by 11 volt, we can find the current flowing. Okay? Now see, these two are in parallel. These four are in parallel. These two are in parallel. Yes or no? So, can we easily find out the total resistance of the network? Yes, of course. So, we can convert this into R1 by 2. R1 by 2, R3 by 2. And it will be R1 by 2. Yes or no? And across each, there is an 11 volt source like this. Okay, now see, all are in series, yes or no? So, we can put like, total resistance or R equivalent will be R1 by 2 plus R1 by 2 parallel to R3 by 2 plus R1 by 2. Yes or no? Now, we know the value of R1, 1 ohm. We know the value of R3 equal to 3 ohm. Can we put all the values? Right? So, R equivalent will be R1 by 2 plus R1 by 2 become R1, which is 1 ohm plus 1 by 2 parallel to 3 by 2. Okay? Like this, after solving this, you will get 11 by 8 ohms. After solving this, you will get 11 by 8 ohms. Correct? Now, we know the total resistance of this network. We know the voltage across it. So, finally, the current will be voltage upon R equivalent, which means 11 upon 11 by 8 equal to 8 ampere. Equal to 8 ampere, which is the answer. So, you can see, by using a symmetry concept, you can easily simplify your network. But for symmetry concept, you have to follow the procedure stepwise. Okay? Now, you can see, we have short circuit the nodes B and C and T and E. Okay? We can also make it an open circuit. Okay? If I am making it an open circuit, you can see, this will be open, and then what will happen? All four resistance R1, R3, R3, R1 comes in parallel. Again, we can find out the total resistance by using the same steps, right? So, you can solve this question in this way also. Or, you can draw a horizontal line of symmetry also. Okay, you can draw horizontal line of symmetry and see what will happen. See, if I draw horizontal line of symmetry. Okay, you can see there is a mirror image above it and below it. So, for horizontal line of symmetry, first of all, identify the line of symmetry. See, this line of symmetry is perpendicular to the axis. Yes or no? Which means this is a perpendicular line of symmetry. Now, listen carefully. What will happen in a perpendicular line of symmetry? In perpendicular line of symmetry, the branches which are parallel to it contain equipotential nodes, which means the branches which are parallel to the line of symmetry. You can see the branch BC and ED are parallel to it, right? Which means these both branches contain the equipotential points, or we can say B, C and E, D are equipotential points. So, this is the main conclusion comes from here. You can draw either perpendicular line of symmetry or parallel line of symmetry. The equipotential points will remain same for a particular network if the terminal is same. Terminal means across which you have to find the total resistance. So, you can see the equipotential points are same. And again, you can either short circuit it or open circuit it. You will get the same answer. Okay? So, this was the question coming again. Now, for your homework, the homework is you have to find the resistance between BC. Okay? You have to find resistance between BC. And after finding out, post your answer in a comment box. Okay? In a comment below. Thank you. Keep watching and subscribe our channel.